Welcome to the participants of the AIB All India Bar Examination 17th Cohort 2023. Today is a Civil Procedure Code. Now you read what I posted on the screen. Anyone can unmute and read. I said anyone can unmute and read what I posted on the screen.
Welcome to the aspirants of AIBE 17-2023, MCQ in Civil Procedure Code, Virtual Class on 16-1-2023, CPC, by Professor Dr. Muhammad Sahib Hussain, Professor of Law, South Mwanza, Tanzania.
Very good. Now, without wasting the time, we will concentrate on the multiple choice question. And we dealt in my last class up to the 17th question. Be ready for the 18th question. Yes, 18th question is, the judgment discussed below majority throw light on the dash of the case in comparison to the dash. Option A, obiter dictum and ratio decidendi. B, ratio dictum and obiter decidendi. C, ratio obiter and dictum decidendi. D, ratio decidendi and obiter dictum. Which one is the right option among A, B, C, D? Shoot! I said shoot! Participants, are you there?
Option B, sir, ratio dictum and obiter decidendi.
Repeat.
Option B, sir.
Option D, ratio decidendi and obiter dictum is the right answer for the 18th question. Now, 19th question. Whether the case is maintainable under Section 151 of the Civil Procedure Code is discussed in the case of dash. A, M.S. Khalsa versus Chiranjee Lal and others. B, Mohanlal Goenka versus Binoy Krishna Mukherjee and others. C, Reliance Industry Limited versus Parveen Bhai Joshua Patel. D, M. Srinivas versus Jawaharlal Nehru Technological University. Shoot, which is the right answer? Participants, your silence will kill me.
Option B, sir, Mohanlal Goenka versus Binoy Krishna Mukherjee and others.
WRONG.
Option A, sir.
MS Khalsa versus Chiranjee Lal and others. That is the right answer for the 19th question. Now, 20th question. All the judgments discussed upholds the underlying principle of the Code of 1908, which is dash, which signifies that where there is a right, there is always a remedy to safeguard the right when infringed. A, demnum sine injurium. B, ubijus ibi remedium. C, sine injuria demnum. D, ibi remedium ubijus. Shoot, A, B, C, D answer.
B.
Write full. Read full.
Ubijus ibi remedium.
The answer is ubijus ibi remedium is the right answer for 20th question. That means where there is a right, there is always a remedy. That is the answer. Supplementary question. What is trio maxims in law of tract? Trio or trio? T-R-I-O. Anyone? The trio maxims are, number one, demnum sine injuria. Number two, sine injuria demnum. Number three, ebi jus ebi remedium. These are the three trio maxims in the law of tract. Okay, 21st question. The court noted that Order 8, Rule 1 of the Code of Civil Procedure 1908 is a mandatory provision, and therefore applying the same opinion, the delay in filing the appeal was not to be accepted in the case of Dash. A. Government Maharashtra Water Resource Department, represented by the Executive Engineer, versus Mr. Borse Brothers and Engineers and Contractors Private Limited, 2021. B. NV International versus State of Assam. C. Dahi Behan versus Arvindabhai Kalyanji Bhanusali. D. MS Khalsa versus Chiranji Lal and others. Participants, shoot. Which case law deals about the 21st question? There is no native mass. Shoot.
Option C, sir. Dahi Behan versus Arvind Bhai Kalyanji Bhanusali.
Wrong. Second option.
Option A, sir.
Option A is the right answer. Is the government of Maharashtra, within parenthesis, Water Resource Department, represented by the Executive Engineer, versus Mrs. Borse Brothers Engineering and Contractor Private Limited. That is the case law. 22nd question. Anyone can unmute and read loudly.
The judgments discussed below have been taken from various high courts dash India. A. Crossways. B. Crosswise. C. Diagonally. D. Across.
Yes. Here I am showing the cursor. 22nd question. Which is the right option? A, B, C, D, M, M. Here. Which is the appropriate word in the blank?
Across, sir.
Yeah, just a minute. It is sharing. Yes, now it could see. You could see now. You say it is a crossway? Bree crosswise. Shoot, even though there is no negative marks. Participants.
Option C.
Wrong. Option D is the right answer. Across. The judgment discussed below have been taken from the various high courts across India. That is the right answer. 23rd question. The respondent in the present case had filed an application under Order 7, Rule 11 of the Code of Civil Procedure 1998, challenging the suit instituted by the plaintiff on the ground that the same will not be maintainable under the Delhi Cooperative Societies Act 2003. Options. A. Hakim Muhammad Habibuddin versus Muhammad Habibur Rahman died. B. Union of India and another versus Unisetti Sachinarayana. See, somebody is speaking and I could there hear their voice. They did not mute it. I can tell you who did not mute it here, because I could see their voice. Now they are muted. Yes, please, when you speak at the time, you unmute and speak. Okay, now let us resume. B, Union of India and another versus Kunisetty Satyanarayana. C, Virendra Singh versus Delhi State Cooperative Bank Limited. D, Beer Singh versus Bandhu Ram and others. In which case law it is decided? 23rd question. Options A, B, C, D are given.
Option C, sir.
Option C is the right answer. Virendra Singh versus Delhi State Cooperative Bank Limited. In that case law, it is decided above manner. 24th question. Salient feature of the Code of Civil Procedure, CPC, which is not exactly the proper answer among the four options. I say, which is not the exact answer among the four options. A, the code contains a procedure to be implemented by courts. B, the code provides the means to enforce the rights and liabilities. C, the code does not impact local or the spiritual laws. D, the code has been amended many times to meet the changing requirement. And which is not the exact, not I said, not exact the proper answer among the four. Yes, somebody is speaking by keeping open. Lakshman, mute. When you want to speak at the time, you unmute and speak. Yes, anyone?
Option Should, D, sir.
Yes.
The code has been amended many times to meet the changing requirements.
That is not an exact answer. I say, which is not exact the proper answer among the options. You clearly observe.
Option B, sir.
The code provides the means to enforce the rights and liabilities. It is also, see, feedback I have given. The code contains the procedure to be implemented by the civil courts. Means A is not the exact answer. Because in the what I did it, by I removed the civil and put the courts. So what is the right answer?
Option A.
Civil
Option A.
Court. Civil should be inserted. Civil should be inserted over there. I removed the civil. So it is not an exact answer for that one. Okay, now 25th question. The court in the case dash concluded that as the appellate had failed to show that the decree did not fall within any of the exceptions provided under section 13 of the code, the appeal was dismissed. A. Mrs. International Woolen Mills versus Mr. Standard Wool UK Limited. B. Arvind Jaram Kotecha versus Prabhudas Damodar Kotecha. C. Balraj Taneja and another versus Sunil Madan and another. D. Brijlal Ramji Das versus Goindram G. Seksaria. Which is the right option among the ABCD for the 25th question? Anyone can shoot?
Option A, sir.
Wrong. Second option. Don't kill the time.
Option B, sir. Arvind
Jaram. Option B is the right answer. Arvind Jaram Kotecha versus Prabhudas Damodar Kotecha. That is the right answer for the 25th question. Now 26th question. Anyone can unmute and read?
The following are some of the important judgments delivered by the Supreme Court which deals with CPC. Appellate courts jurisdiction under section dash CPC involves rehearing on questions of law as well as option A 93, option B 94, option C 95, option D 96.
Shoot, which is the right answer among the A, B, C, D? Participants, you have to speak. Even though it is wrong, there is no negative marks.
Option C, sir, 95.
Wrong. The right answer is option D, 96. I repeat, right answer is option D, 96 for the 26th question. Now, 27th question. Section 15 of the CPC, quote on which suits to be instituted. A. Every suit shall be instituted in the court of the bottom grade competent to try it. B. Every suit shall be instituted in the court of the lowermost grade competent to try it. C. Every suit shall be instituted in the court of the last grade competent to try it. D. Every suit shall be instituted in the court of the lowest grade competent to try it. Which is the right option?
Option D, sir. Every suit shall be instituted in the court of the lowest grade competent to try it.
It is the correct answer. D is the correct answer. As per the section 15, every suit shall be instituted in the court of the lowest grade competent to try it. That is the right answer. Now, anyone can unmute and read the 28th question. Kick.
It said section dash of the CPC provides for civil courts to invoke their inherent jurisdiction and utilize the same to meet the ends of justice or to prevent the abuse of process. Option A 149, option B 150, option C 151, option D 152.
Shoot, which is the right answer?
Option C 152, sir. Option C 151, sir.
Yes, it is option C. 151 is the right answer for the 28th question. I appreciate. 29th. Which case law deals with the section 151 of the CPC? 1. Kesher Dio Chamriya versus Radha Kishan Chamriya and others. B. Bhinya Ram sons of Shera Ram versus Hukma Ram. 3. Jyoti Prasad versus Rameshwar Nath and others. 4. Nathu Ram versus Gaon Sabha. Then the options are A 1 plus 2, B 2 plus 3, C 3 plus 4, D 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. I give the four cases. If the four cases, whether they deals with the section 151 or not of CPC, then I give the A, B, C, D options. Then which option is the right option for the 29th question?
B, 2 plus 3, sir.
Wrong.
Option C, sir, 3 plus 4.
Wrong. Try. Sir, 1 plus 2. Wrong.
Option D, 1 plus 2 plus 3, sir.
Answer is I did not change anything because all the cases deals with the section 151 of the CPC. So the right answer is D, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 is the right answer for the 29th question. Now, 30th question. An interesting question regarding the interpretation of the section 10 Civil Procedure Code arises in the revision petition as to the meaning and contents of the expression "the trial of any suit" was observed in the case of. Here I give the A. SARM SPA Annamalai Chetty versus SARMS SP Palniappa. B. Gulsham BV versus Ahmed Shah Rauthar. C. Munnilal versus Sarait. D. Hiralal Ichalalal versus Narsilal Chaturbhujas. Chaturbhujdas. Among the A, B, C, D, which is the right option for the 38th question? Shoot.
Option D, sir.
Wrong.
Option C, sir. Munilal versus Sarvajit.
Option C is the right answer. There is a Munilal versus Sarvajit is the right answer for the 30th question. 31st question. Which is the correct statement under the section 10 of the CPC? And here A. The section 10 provides the regulation of procedures, although it is mandatory in the sense that if a party applies for the same, the trial of the subsequently instituted suit during the pendency of the previously instituted suit or an appeal or second appeal arising therefrom, then the court has no alternative but to say. B. The section 10 provides a rule of the procedure, and although it is a mandatory in the sense that if a party applies for saying the trial of the subsequently instituted suit during the pendency of the previously instituted suit or in appeal or subsequent appeal arising therefrom from the court has no alternative but to stay. C. Does the section 10 provide certain instructions of the procedure, and although it is mandatory in the sense that if a party applies for saying the trial of the subsequently instituted suit during the pendency of the previously instituted suit or an appeal or second appeal arising therefrom, then the court has no alternative but to stay. The D. Does the section 10 provides a rule of the procedure, and although it is mandatory in the sense that it is a party applies for the staying the trial of the subsequently instituted suit during the pendency of the previously instituted suit or an appeal or second appeal arising therefrom, then the court has no alternative but to say. So I give the total A, B, C, D. Now I want to ask you which is the correct option among the A, B, C, D. It is about the section 10.
Option D, correct answer.
Which one? Which one? Say. Repeat. Again, you got the doubt. First you say.
Option.
So and so is the right answer, sir. When I say repeat, means you are silent. Participants, your silence will kill me.
Option B, sir.
Option D is the right answer here. The section 10 provides the rule of procedures, and although it is mandatory in the sense that if a party applies for the saying, the trial of the subsequently instituted suit during the pendency of the previously instituted suit or an appeal or second appeal arising therefrom, then the court has no alternative but to stay. Then what is the wrong in A? Can you tell me? I say rules of procedures, but what I did it here? What I did it here? Regulations I made it there. Instead of rule, what I did?
Regulation
I put it over here. In place of rule. Is it clear? Then what is wrong in the B? Check it. Yes. Subsequent appeal. But what is actually? It is the second appeal. Did you observe here?
Yes, sir.
Actually, the second appeal, but what I did it, subsequent appeal, I said. Okay, what is wrong in C?
Provides an instruction of procedure, sir. Instruction.
So, what I did it?
Instead of rule, you put instruction, sir.
Yes. Provides an instruction instead of rule. So, what is the right answer?
Option D, sir.
Option D is the right answer. Okay, anyone can unmute and read the 32nd question.
When was CPC last amended? Option A, Code of Civil Procedure Code, within parenthesis, Amendment Act 2001. Option B, Code of Civil Procedure Amendment Act 2002. Option C, Code of Civil Procedure Amendment Act 2003. Option D, Code of Civil Procedure Amendment Act 2004. Option B, sir.
Option B is the right answer. Code of Civil Procedure within parenthesis Amendment Act of 2002 is the right answer. But I try to make it how many times the CPC is amended. I tried my level best to find it, but I could not. Of course, time factor also another point in searching. There is a probability that how many times CPC is amended. For instance, if you ask how many times Constitution is amended? 105. So the Act number 22 of the 2002, 23rd May 2002, an act further to amend the Code of the Civil Procedure 1998 to provide for the matters connected therewith or incidental thereto is number one. The act may be called the Code of Civil Procedure within parenthesis Amendment Act of 2002. So now the next question. What was the first case in the Supreme Court of India? I repeat, which was the first case in the Supreme Court of India? I did not say civil case, criminal case, nini, nani, no. A. Menaka Gandhi versus Union of India. B. Eka Gopalan versus State of Madras. C. Ajay Singh, Lehana Singh versus the State of Punjab and others. And D. ADM Jabalpur versus Shivakant Shukla.
Option B, sir, A.K. Gopalan versus the State of Madras.
Can you tell me what is the A.K. Gopalan case, State of Madras? It's about what?
Article 21, sir, something.
He is illegally detained and his detention is void, they said. But they say it is not violated with Article 21, it says over there. What about the Menaka Gandhi versus Union of India?
It is under article, related to article 19.
Whenever the anybody's liberty is curtailed, it should be curtailed in the due process of law. That impounding of the passport, article 21. Then ADM Jabalpur versus Shivakant Shukla. I think it is a habeas corpus. What is ADM? What is ADM? Assistant District Magistrate, if I am not mistaken. So, January 28, 1950, Supreme Court of India officially inaugurated, starts the functioning from the Chamber of the Princes in the Parliament House. May 19, 1950, A.K. Gopalan versus State of Madras, one of the first in which the court can opportunity to interpret the Article 21. In this case law, whether the A.K. Gopalan won the case? Answer is no. Okay. What are the three common types of civil cases? I would like to test you how far that you could make it out. A. Number one, tort claims. Two, contract breaches. Three, motor accident claims. Four, landlord and tenant issues. And A, 1 plus 2. B, 2 plus 3. C, 1 plus 2 plus 4. D, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4.
Option C, sir. 1 plus 2 plus 4.
I appreciate, because I made concoction of 1 plus 2, that is motor vehicle. Actually, there is no motor vehicle case loss. Why? Motor vehicle case law is both civil and criminal case law. For the compensation, a private individual file a case. For the accident, the police will case file a case. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Good, good. Now, 35th question. The case of Dash is an appeal case brought before the Supreme Court of India to challenge a judgment delivered by the Gujarat High Court that declared a suit filed by the appellant to be barred by the limitation under Rule 11 Clause D, Order 7 of the Code of the Civil Procedure 1998. Jayesh Kumar Mathur Bhai Patel versus Mukesh Bhai Varshi Bhai Desai. B. Sher Singh Yadav versus Ash Kapoor and others. C. Vidarbha Ceramic Private Limited versus Anupama Dago, daughter of Vivek Daga. And D. Dahi Behen versus Arvind Bhai Kalyanji Bansali. Which is the right answer? Yes. Which is the right answer? Shoot, even though it is wrong, doesn't matter.
Sir, option D.
Option D is the right answer. Dahi Behen versus Arvind Bhai Kalyanji Bhanusali is the right answer. 36th question. Anyone can unmute and read? As I read.
Section 16. Suits to be instituted where subject matter situate. Subject to the pecuniary or the other limitations prescribed by any laws. Suit. 1. For the recovery of immovable property with or without rent or profits. 2. For the partition of immovable property. 3. For the foreclosure, sale or redemption in the case of mortgage or of or charge upon movable property. 4. Or the determination of any other right to or interest in immovable property. A. 1 plus 2. B. 1 plus 3. C. 1, 2, 4. D. 1, 3, 4.
Shoot.
C is right answer, sir. 1 plus 2 plus 4.
Sir, option D, 1 plus 3 plus 4.
If I say right, then why it is right? If I say wrong, why it is wrong? Regarding the D is concerned. Regarding the C is concerned, yes, it is right, but why it is right? Somebody using songs in their house. I could hear the sound. Hey, Venkat Reddy.
Yes, sir.
You did not make the mute. I could hear your songs from your house. Yes, I will give the answer. See, these are all for the immovable property. Am I right? But here I wrote the mobile property.
Mobile property you wrote, sir. Actually,
I wrote here the mobile property. Hence, wrong one is 3. When you remove the 3, what is the right option? C. 1 plus 2 plus 4. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that is why I have to give the answer for that one. Okay, now I will read it because it's a lengthy question. Mute. I said mute. Who did not mute it, I could see here. Yeah, now everybody mute. Okay. Otherwise, now I will get the sound from your side. Okay, 37th question, section 27. Summons to defendants. Which one is the correct option? 1. Where a suit has been duly instituted, summons may be issued to the defendant to appear and answer the claim and may be served in a manner set. 2. Where a suit has been duly instituted, summons may be issued to the defendant to appear and answer the claim and may be served in manner agreed. 3. Where a suit has been duly instituted, summons may be issued to the defendant to appear and answer the claim and may be served in a manner prearranged. 4. Where the suit has been duly instituted, summons may be issued to the defendant to appear and answer the claim and may be served in a manner prescribed. As per the section 27 of the CPC, summons to the defendant. There is written A, B, C, D, but I changed 1, 2, 3, 4. Condition means clauses. And which clause is wrong clause, which clause is right clause among the 1, 2, 3, 4. Here I have given the option. A, 1 plus 2, B, 2 plus 3, C, 3, D, 4. I say correct answer.
1 plus 2, sir.
Run.
Yeah. Sir, option D?
Option D is the correct answer. See, I all changed. Manner set, no manner set. Manners agreed, no manners agreed. Manners prearranged, no manners prearranged. Manners prescribed. Is it clear? See this one, I already changed the last words, but here I did not change.
Yes, sir.
So, D is the right answer, which is exact wordings of summons served to the defendant. Shall I proceed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, 38th question. Mode of making attachment. Which option is the correct option? Number one, save as otherwise expressly provided, the attachment shall be made in the manner provided for the attachment of the property in the execution of a verdict. 2. Save otherwise expressly provided, the attachment shall be made in the manner provided for the attachment of the property in the execution of a declaration. 3. Save or otherwise expressly provided, attachment shall be made in the manner provided for the attachment property in the execution of ruling. 4. Save as otherwise expressly provided, the attachment shall be made in the manner provided for the attachment of the property in the execution of a decree. Options A plus 2, option B 2 plus 3, option C 3, option D 4.
D is the right answer, sir. 4.
4 is the right answer. Actually, yes, I thought of changing the order, but again I forgotten. If I change the order now, a bit you will be confused. But I did not change the order. But anyway, it doesn't matter because you know now how the question will be framed. Is it clear?
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
See, I am showing a different style of making the question and to find out which is the correct answer, which is the wrong answer. So, in different permutation combinations, I am using to see that how the questions should be framed. I told you already, you cannot get such a questions in anywhere in the book, which is there in the market. It is my creativity of my brain. It is my creativity of my
brain, sir.
Brain. That is the thing which I want to make it out. Of course, the next class is Evidence Act is there, which is on 17th and 18th, and the questions may be framed in any manner they like it, but the only thing is you should be very much cautious enough how you have to answer the questions. That is a very talented things one should have to develop it. I kept here your CPC Bear Act. Here it is there. CPC Bear Act. Yes. So I did not ask the questions. How many parts are there? How many sections are there? And in which part the sections are many? In which part the sections are very less? And what are the parts? Name of the parts. For instance, you take part 2 is an execution of a execution. So in this way, now you tell me where the res judicata comes in this CPC. Anyone? Supplementary question. In which section res judicata comes?
11, sir.
I appreciate. See, it is given here, see. Res judicata, section 11.
Yes, sir.
What is meant by res judicata?
Thing of done.
Yes, the thing which is already done. That means the case is disposed. Again, the same type of the case, having the facts cannot be entertained again. The same applicable, what is the disposition earlier would be there in particular state. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So, a supplementary questions also can be asked in a such a way. And which section says about the interest in the CPC? Interest, INTEREST. See, here I have given section 34, interest is there. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So,
yes, sir.
They may ask the questions. At one side, they will write the res judicata and interest, cost, and penalty of fault, default. In the part B side, they write the sections and they may either they ask the mismatch or match. Either they ask mismatch or match. By either way, they can ask the questions. So you should be in a position to give the answer, shoot the answer by using your techniques which I taught you, the fishing techniques. The angling techniques. Angling is nothing but fishing. Fishing with the stick is called angling. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And they may be asked how many sections repealed. See, the repealed one there. How many sections they repealed, they may ask you in that manner also. So at that time, you have to see how you can shoot it. So these are the various ways a question can be framed. And I do have the questions here. When the time permits, no, we will do it because somebody has sent me the questions. I think it is a Sweta something or Kanaka Durga. But there is AIB. This is AIB 14, set A. This is set A. Sir, it is a different way it is showing, sir. You can change it. You can rotate it automatically. Because here rotation, I think it is covered by my other things. Otherwise, they can rotate. Yeah, I made rotation here. So, Bar Council of India, All India Bar Examination and cohort, 14th cohort, this is. It is a 2019. So, they say language, English is there here. And of course, which of the following is not a case of public interest litigation? Oh, they say, see here, for instance, you take here, which of the following is not a case of a public interest litigation? Keshavananda Bharati versus State of Kerala, Vincent Narayana versus Union of India, Union of India versus Association of the Democratic Reforms, and Vincent Pani Kurlangara versus Union of India. So the four options are given over here. Which one is that?
Right answer. Keshavananda Bharati versus State of Kerala.
Which is not a public interest litigation.
Yes, sir.
So they can file a case in a different way also, so that they could know that how we can make it out. And they can also ask the question in the different manner. Right here they have given writ of certiorari can be issued against A. Judicial and quasi-judicial bodies. B. Quasi-judicial and administrative bodies. C. Administrative bodies only. D. None of the above. Certiorari.
Sir, once again, sir.
Certiorari. Writ of certiorari can be issued against A. Judicial and quasi-judicial bodies. B. Quasi-judicial and administrative bodies. C. Administrative bodies only. D. None of the above.
Question number, sir.
ऑप्शन ए जुडिशरी एंड क्वासी जुडिशरी.
सर
यस
वंस अगेन क्वेश्चन नंबर्स प्लीज.
हियर हियर ऑप्शन 19th
19th
I believe that judicial and quasi judicial bodies they should
judicial
share
and
the
quasi
duty.
judicial, sir.
Yeah, that is the right
Exactly.
answer.
Very
See, if you
right answer.
just have a knowledge of it, a little knowledge, enough, you can shoot it. Because you can follow the deductive method and you can shoot it. So that is the way we can also make it out. And this is the way where we can know that what nature of the question they can ask. For instance, you take 27th question where I am moving the cursor. For the first time in India, income tax was introduced by Sir James Wilson
Sir,
in
answer is 1860, sir. Sir, answer is 1860.
Yes. See, they can ask at least this way also. At the first time when it is introduced. So,
Sir, James
the nature
Wilson,
of
sir.
when it is enacted, enforced and enacted. And how many times income tax was amended? And what is the latest amendment of the income tax? So, such a questions they may ask you in the examination. And here, for instance, you take the 23rd question. The Kashmira Singh versus State of MP is a leading case on either dying declaration, admission, confession to the police officer, D, confession of a co-accused.
Sir, D is right answer, sir. Confession of a co-accused.
Okay. The Kashmira Singh versus State of MP, the leading case.
Absolutely correct, sir.
Yeah, and there is one more leading case I could make it to. That is R versus Abdullah.
Sir?
R versus Abdullah. It's a very landmark case there. And that leading case law, especially that, not necessarily. A written statement should be there. Even a sign, gestures can also be a dying declaration. It conveys. Because in the case law, what happened? His trachea means larynx, sound box. ఏమంటారు అండి దాన్ని నాళ్ళమంటారా? అది హిస్ట్రీ చేసిండ్రు దానికి మాట్లాడేది సౌండ్ బాక్స్ ఉన్న కాడ. And he was severed over there. Now he cannot speak and give the declaration. And he shows with the signs, with the gestures. And the gestures is considered to be the dying declaration in that case law. Of course, there is another a landmark case law to be there in the Padukone Subbaiah versus Andhra Pradesh case law, that is. That is also a landmark case law in the dying declaration. I have forgotten the case law. Anyway, tomorrow is there no evidence. I can repeat, I can tell you that which case law is there. Padukola Subbarao versus something. I have forgotten the name of the case law. If you don't repeat it and you forget it. Suppose if I shown the option, I can easily shoot. Because option gives the sense, somewhere you read it, and that recollection would be there. With that recollection, we can shoot it. So, some of the cases we can go through it and we can get it. See, in the Macnaughton rules, from the basis of the law of infancy, insanity, ignorance of the fact, or mistake. Macnaughton rules.
Insanity, sir.
It's insanity.
Yes,
So, with
sir.
that, we can easily make it out which will be the proper thing where we can shoot it. So, this is the, I am showing a model for you so that how you can frame the questions and how can shoot it, what are the things are there. See, this is another very interesting thing. 56th question. Here, 56. From which of the following countries the Constitution of India has borrowed power of judicial review? Judicial review, Canada, United Kingdom, USA, or Ireland? To my knowledge, it is a USA.
Yes, sir. USA is right answer.
Judicial review, to my knowledge.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. USA. Absolutely correct.
No, because why you should have to get the confusion? See,
No confusion, sir.
let me check. A judicial review
No confusion.
is borrowed from which country? USA. See, I taught
USA,
you,
sir.
that's why I could remember the things in my mind. So, but still, one can check it. India has borrowed the certain features like the fundamental rights, judicial review, independence of judiciary, functions of the president and vice president, and impeachment of the president from the USA. Was this answer helpful? Yeah, that is the thing where we can make it out from where we borrowed and how we borrowed. See, this is the way that we can ask the question and deal the questions, and we can go forward also. And I don't know why till because the time is up to my knowledge, because 7:34 to me, and we started at the 6:40. Okay. Today is Cisco Webex is very kind enough. It is not showing the time factor now. Otherwise, they clearly mentioned 5 minutes are there. So that was the thing. Let me see some of the questions, how we can make it out. For instance, which one of the following section, Consumer Protection Act 1986, how could he give 1986? Oh, at the time it is not there because it came in the 2019. Perhaps at the time, the still 1986 is in operation. Defines the term consumer. So, A, B, C, D. Who is a consumer is given 20. Subsection 1A, 21B, 21C. I think it's a 21C. 21C, to my knowledge. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
To the consumer, consumer. Who is the consumer? So, as per the new act is 2019. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
And they may ask also that 2019, when it became effective implementation of the act. I came to know it is 2021, June. It's the full provisions of the Consumer Protection Act is in enforcement. The full. I'm speaking about the full. See, even though Act is made in advance, but it cannot be implemented unless until rules are framed. When the rules are framed, only any act would be regulated. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So that is the way we can make it our thing. Let us see some of them here. This is a very easy thing, I think. Declaration on 10th schedule is taken by President, Chief Justice of India, C, Prime Minister, or D, Presiding Officer of the Houses. Decisions on 10th schedule is taken by. First, we should know what is the 10th schedule. And Presiding Officer of the
President,
House.
sir. A is right answer, sir. President.
It's by president. So certain sometimes no, it is very close should be there. It should be very much cautious enough before you are shooting. Otherwise, no, we'll lose the marks. Of course, lose the marks means there is no negative marks. If the negative marks are there, very few people will pass. I challenge, very few people will pass if the negative marks are there. So here also the interest power under Section 482 of the CRPC can be exercised by, they have given the option, it must be given by the merits of the case, B, it must be pronounced by the court. No, this is the answer. Okay, now shall I close down or can we discuss something till it will be closed? Yes?
We
Sir,
can
good night,
discuss
sir.
more, sir.
Yes? Shall we close down?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So as per the today and the tomorrow we'll meet at the same timings, 9:10 to 10. And the tomorrow topic is the law of evidence. And you read it and come with the full preparation so that you could shoot it as soon as I spelled out the last option. So with this, I would like to stop my today's meeting, end of the meeting, and Jai Hind.
Jai Hind!